হ্যালো ভিউয়ার্স, ওয়েলকাম টু স্মার্ট পাঠশালা। আজকে ডিফেন্স রিলেটেড নতুন একটি ভিডিও নিয়ে তোমাদের সাথে শেয়ার করতে এসেছি। দিস ভিডিও ইজ অ্যাবাউট অফিসার এন্ট্রিজ আফটার গ্রাজুয়েশন। সো দিস আর দ্য 8 এন্ট্রিজ ইউ ক্যান জয়েন ইন্ডিয়ান আর্মি, ইন্ডিয়ান এয়ারফোর্স অ্যান্ড ইন্ডিয়ান নেভি অ্যাজ অ্যান অফিসার বাই দিস 8 এন্ট্রিজ। সো লেটস ডিসকাস। ফার্স্ট ওয়ান ইজ CDS, কম্বাইন্ড ডিফেন্স সার্ভিসেস এক্সাম। দিস ইজ এ রিটেন এক্সাম, আই উইল ডিসকাস ইট লেটার। Second one is the TGC entry, Technical Graduate Course. Third one is SSC Tech. This SSC stands for Short Service Commission. Fourth one is SSC Non-Technical. Fifth one is University Entry Scheme. Sixth one is INET. This exam is only exclusively for Indian Navy. The seventh one is FCAT, Air Force Common Admission Test. This exam is also exclusive for Indian Air Force. Eighth one is SSC JUG. SSC JUG stands for the lawyers who wants to serve the Indian Defence Forces as a lawyer. This entry is for them. SSC JUG entry. So today I will discuss about the written exam CDS, and I will note you down about the age limits and eligibility criteria about these four entries. So let's discuss about the entries available for Indian Army. First one is CDS. These are the age limits. Second one is TGC, third one is SSC Tech, fourth one is SSC Non-Technical, and fifth one is University Entry Scheme. These are the age limits. You can have a screenshot of these entries. You can take a screenshot. These all five entries are for available for Indian Army only. So you can take a screenshot here. So let's discuss about CDS examination. CDS examination journal chapter একাডেমি অ্যালোটেড করা। ফার্স্ট ওয়ান ইজ IMA দেরাদুন, OTA চেন্নাই, INA আজিমালা এন্ড এয়ারফোর্স একাডেমি হায়দ্রাবাদ। সো দ্য প্যাটার্ন উইল বি ফর IMA, INA এন্ড AFA, দ্য সাবজেক্টস আর ইংলিশ 100 মার্কস, এলিমেন্টারি ম্যাথমেটিক্স, নট 11th অর 12th ম্যাথমেটিক্স, ইটস এলিমেন্টারি ম্যাথমেটিক্স এন্ড জেনারেল নলেজ 100 মার্কস। থ্রি পেপার্স আর অফ 100 মার্কস ইচ। The written examination will be of 2 hours for each of subject. This who are opting IMA, INA and AFA as preferences, they will get permanent commission. Next is CDS has a two varieties of exam. First one is permanent commission and second one is short service commission. Girls can only opt CDS examination as a short commission candidate. So the subjects in the short commission exam are English and GK only. There are only two papers, each of 100 marks same. This is the who are opting for CDS short service commission will train at OTA Chennai for Indian under Indian Army Guardians. So next one is TGC entry, Technical Graduate Course. Age limit 21 to 27. This is also permanent commission and training academy is IMA Dehradun. What is the eligibility criteria? Unmarried male candidates only can opt for this entry. This is a direct entry and no written exam is conducted for this. The shortlisted candidate will be directly called for SSB interview. What is the qualification? BTech holders in notified streams. When the notification will come out, there will be some streams which are vacant. So BTech holders can only opt for TGC entry. This is a permanent commission and only male candidates can opt for this exam. Training academy will be IMA Dehradun, Indian Military Academy Dehradun. So next one is SSC Tech and SSC Non-Technical entries. SSC Tech for age limit is 19 to 27 years. SSC Non-Technical is for 19 to 25 years. Both of them, the candidates opting for both entries or each one will train at OTA Chennai or either OTA Gaya. What is the qualification? BTech holders again in the notified streams, in the notified vacant streams, and unmarried male and female candidates can opt for these two entries. Both male and female candidates can opt for these two entries. This university entry scheme, age limit is 21 to 27. This is a permanent commission and trained at IMA Dehradun. What is the eligibility? Unmarried male candidates only. আমি এখানে এডুকেশনাল কোয়ালিফিকেশনটা উল্লেখ করছি না, কারণ ইউএস ইউনিভার্সিটি এন্ট্রি স্কিমটা বছরে একবারই বের হয়। এটা অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইন্ডিয়ান আর্মির জন্য বের হয়, ইন্ডিয়ান নেভির জন্য বের হয়, দুটা স্ট্রিমের জন্য বের হয় অ্যাকচুয়ালি। তো এখানে বিটেক হোল্ডার্সরা ইউনিভার্সিটি এন্ট্রি স্কিমটা অপ করতে পারে, শুধু মেল ক্যান্ডিডেটসরা। তো সেখানেও same criteria should be BTEC holders in vacant streams only. So next is INET. This is also SSC Commission exam, Indian Navy entrance test. Education qualification is minimum 60% in each of maths and physics in 10 plus 2 or equivalent. That means you have must acquire minimum 60% marks in each of the subjects maths and physics in 12. Both male and female candidates can apply for this. Another education qualification is that they must be BTEC graduates. Only BTEC graduates can opt for INET exam. The 7th number is FCAT, Air Force Common Admission Test. This exam is also short service commission and both male and female candidates are eligible for this exam. Educational qualification again, minimum 60% marks in each of maths and physics in 10 plus 2 or equivalent. Another educational qualification is that BSc, BA or BTEC graduates can opt for FCAT examination. Point to be noted that BA graduates can only opt for ground duty as an officer to join the Indian Air Force. Training institute is Indian Air Force Academy, Hyderabad. Okay, the 8th one is SSC JAG entry. Age limit is 21 to 27 years. Education qualification, graduate in LLB with minimum 55% marks and eligible to enroll as advocate in Bar Council of India. Both male and female candidates can apply for this. This is also a short service commission entry. No written exam is conducted, only SSB interview is conducted through shortlisting. This is also a special entry for NCC cadets. The special entry is NCC entry. Age limit is 19 to 25 years. Graduate with at least 50%, 2 years service in NCC and with minimum B grade in NCC certificate exam. This entry is available for both male and female candidates. This is an exclusive entry and conducted 2 times or at least 1 times in a year. Okay, so these are some of the entries you can opt after graduation. You can opt after graduation to enter Indian Armed Forces as an officer. If you have any question, any queries related to this lecture, you can ask in the comment section. I will bring some more videos in my upcoming sessions. Till then, stay tuned.